What is layered software architecture? It's a hierarchical structuring of Autosar software with the basic software module mapped to different software layers. After looking into all the project objectives of Autosar, let's now look a bit deeper into layered software architecture of Autosar. Before we dive in, let's first try to address the question on what type of ECUs were considered for developing Autosar specification. Autosar is dedicated for automotive ECUs. Such ECUs have the following properties. They have strong interaction with hardware, basically sensors and actuators. They're connected to vehicle networks like CAN, LIN, FlexRay or Ethernet. They have microcontrollers typically of 16 or 32 bit with limited resource of computing power and memory compared to enterprise solutions. They are real-time systems and program execution happens from internal or external flash memory. So one ECU, that is one microcontroller with peripherals and according software configuration, shall have one Autosar ECU instance, which implies there are two or more microcontrollers in an ECU. Each microcontroller requires its own description of an Autosar ECU instance. With this understanding, let's get into our main topic. So what is layered software architecture? It's a hierarchical structuring of Autosar software with the basic software module mapped to different software layers, which will help in understanding the relationship between different modules. At a high abstraction, Autosar architecture contains three software layers: application, runtime environment, RTE, and basic software, BSW. The Autosar basic software is further divided into service layer, ECU abstraction layer, microcontroller abstraction layer, and complex driver layer. Starting with microcontroller abstraction layer, which is the lowest software layer of basic software module, contains internal drivers, which are software modules with direct access to microcontroller and internal peripherals. Objective of microcontroller abstraction layer is to make higher software layers independent of microcontroller. Implementation of microcontroller abstraction layer shall be microcontroller dependent. The layer shall provide standardized interfaces to higher layer, which are independent of microcontroller. Next, we have ECU abstraction layer, which interfaces the drivers of microcontroller abstraction layer. It also contains drivers for external devices. It offers an API for access to peripherals and devices regardless of their location. Either they could be microcontroller internal or external, and their connection to the microcontroller through ports, pins, or any type of interfaces. Objective of ECU abstraction layer is to make higher software layer independent of ECU hardware layout. Implementation of ECU abstraction layer shall be microcontroller independent but ECU hardware dependent. ECU abstraction layer shall provide standardized interface to higher layers, which are independent of microcontroller and ECU hardware layout. Next, let's have a look at complex driver layer. This layer spans from hardware to RTE. Complex driver layer provides the possibility to integrate special purpose functionalities such as drivers for devices which are not specified within Autosar or drivers which have very high time constraints, etc. Implementation of complex driver layer might be application, microcontroller or ECU hardware dependent. Complex driver layer shall provide standardized interface to higher layer, which might be application, microcontroller, and ECU hardware dependent. Lastly, we have service layer, which is the highest layer of basic software. The service layer has its relevance for application software accessing the I/O signals covered by ECU abstraction layer. The service layer offers operating system functionality, vehicle network communication and management services, memory services, diagnostic services including UDS communication, error memory and fault treatment, ECU state management and mode management, logical and temporal program flow monitoring, etc. Objective of service layer is to provide basic services for application, RTE and basic software modules. Implementation of service layer mostly are microcontroller and ECU hardware independent. Service layer shall provide standardized interface to higher layer which are independent of microcontroller and ECU hardware layout. Coming to RTE, the RTE is a layer providing communication services to the application software. It could be Autosar software components or Autosar sensor or Autosar actuator components. Above the RTE, the software architecture style changes from layer to component style architecture. Hence, individual or independent Autosar software components can be integrated above RTE. The Autosar software component communicate with other components inter or intra ECU or through service via RTE. Objective of RTE is to make Autosar software component independent of mapping to a specific ECU. Implementation of RTE is ECU or application specific, generated individually for each ECU. RTE layer shall provide standardized interface to higher layer which are completely ECU independent. Let's now look into the type of services provided by basic software modules. Firstly, the input-output services. Basic software module provides standardized access to sensors, actuators, and ECU onboard peripherals. Next, memory service. Basic software module provides standardized access to internal or external memory, the non-volatile memory. Crypto services. Basic software modules again provides standardized access to cryptographic primitives, including internal or external hardware accelerators. Communication service. Basic software module provides standardized access to vehicle network systems, ECU onboard communication systems, and ECU internal software. Offboard communication service. Basic software module provides standardized access to vehicle to external communication, in-vehicle wireless network systems, ECU offboard communication systems. And lastly, system services. Basic software module provides provision of standardizable service such as operating system, timers, error memory, and ECU specific services such as ECU state management, watchdog manager, and library functions. Upcoming video, we will have a look into the details of each basic software layers. Thank you.